Hello and welcome to Dental Studies Simplified. I am Dr. Ankita Kotecha and today's topic is Sopransky postulate. I will teach you this topic under the set of following questions. Individually, they will help you in bio class and altogether give you a complete answer. To begin with, who gave Sopransky postulate? Sigmund Sopransky. Please remember his name, Sigmund Sopransky. That is why the name of the postulate, Sopransky postulate. Next, why were these postulates introduced? These postulates were introduced to judge whether a microorganism is a potential pathogen causing diseases in humans. To judge whether a microorganism is a potential pathogen causing infections or diseases in humans. Coming to the main part of the topic, what are these postulates? So there are total 5 postulates. I will be teaching them individually. Number 1. Association. Association means the level of the microorganism must increase at the site of the disease. So where there is disease, the level of the microorganisms should be higher levels relatively or increase. Next, decrease or elimination. So when there is clinical healing after the therapy, the level of microorganism should either decrease or eliminate in total. Third, alter host response. The microorganism must be able to alter the host response by affecting immunity, either cellular or humoral. So, alter host response. Please remember, these 3 postulates are based upon humans or individuals. Please keep in mind, these 3 postulates, that is association, elimination or decrease, alter host response, are based on humans or individuals. Whereas the 4th postulate, disease causation, the microorganism must be able to cause the same disease in experimental animals. This is the difference between the first 3 postulates and the 4th postulate. That is, this 4th postulate is based on experimental animal models. The microorganism must be able to cause disease in experimental animal model. And the 5th and the most important postulate, demonstration of virulence cycles. Now, virulence cycles are synonymous to weapons of a warrior in a war. The microorganism must demonstrate such virulence factors with the help of which they mediate the tissue destruction and hence clinically manifest as disease. For example, lycotoxin by Agrigentibacter actinomycetum comitans, lycopolysaccharide by Porphyromonas gingivalis, and as well gingivates. These are few examples of virulence factors that a microorganism possesses. So, a microorganism which one is trying to judge as a potential pathogen causing infections or diseases must demonstrate such virulence factors with the help of which they mediate the tissue destruction and has clinically manifest as disease. So, these are the 5 Sopransky postulates. Coming to the last part of the topic, applied aspects. So, what are the applied aspects? So, based on these 5 postulates, it is accepted that only Agrigentibacter actinomycetum comitans and Porphyromonas gingivalis are accepted as paleopathogens, especially the role of Agrigentibacter actinomycetum comitans in localized aggressive periodontitis and Porphyromonas gingivalis in chronic periodontitis. So this completes our topic of Sopransky postulates. Let's have a quick summary. Sigmund Sopransky gave Sopransky postulates to judge whether a microorganism is a potential pathogen causing diseases or infections in humans. There are total 5 postulates. Number 1, association means the level of microorganisms must increase or be higher levels relatively at the site of disease. Decrease or elimination, when there is clinical resolution of the disease or healing after prolonged therapy, the levels of the microorganism must decrease or ideally eliminate in total. Third is alter host response. The microorganism must be able to alter the host response by affecting immunity. Fourth point is different from the first 3 points because it is based on experimental animal models. The microorganism must be able to cause same disease in experimental animal models. And the fifth and the most important postulate, the microorganisms must demonstrate virulence factors with the help of which they mediate the tissue destruction and hence clinically manifest as the disease. Based upon these postulates, only aggregating factor Actinomycetum comitans and Porphyromonas gingivalis are accepted as periopathogens. So this completes our topic, so Solanski postulates. I hope you find my teaching helpful. If you do, please like my video, share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe to my channel to get notified whenever I upload a new class. Thank you for watching and listening to me.